Hive's effects section comprises a chain of 7 powerful processors with which to enhance, shape and polish the synth's output. Helpfully, the controls for all 7 are housed in the one shared window, making them effortlessly accessible. The whole section is turned on and off using the power button next to the title bar. And individual modules are bypassed by clicking their named buttons in the central column. These buttons also represent the signal flow with input at the top and output at the bottom, and can be reconfigured by dragging them up and down. Let's take a quick tour of the 7 modules. Distortion features controls for input gain, amount, frequency tilt, tone, and wet-dry mix, and 4 core algorithms. Soft and hard clip are the standard analog style saturation modes. Foldback is like soft clip, but folding the peaks back rather than limiting them. And corrode is a combination sample rate reducer and bit crusher. In corrode mode, the amount and tone dials are replaced by the appropriate rate and crush controls. The Chorus Effects 3 algorithms emulate a trio of legendary hardware devices. Classic is the most straightforward and generic of the three. Dramatic is somewhat wilder in terms of modulation. And Ensemble is the thickest and most sumptuous option. The speed and strength of modulation are controlled with the rate and depth knobs. The all-important delay emulates a tape echo unit, switchable between stereo, ping pong and pong ping modes, the last two feeding the left channel into the right and vice versa. Delay times are always synced to host tempo, with note values selected in the left and right menus. Width and feedback control the stereo image and delay circuit regeneration. While a pair of filters are on hand for reining in high and low frequencies. And the diffusion dial smears the delay taps for weight and presence. The delay also features 2 hidden modulation targets that can be set to static values using the constant source or put into motion with Hive's LFOs, envelopes, etc. Timescale slows down or speeds up the delay time relative to the host tempo. and WOW controls the level of low frequency fluctuation produced by the underlying tape delay emulation. Phaser's stoned and flanged modes are again based on two classic hardware effects, with flanged using more delay lines than stoned, making it the more colourful of the two. Crank up the feedback for maximum whoosh. Dynamics and frequency shaping, Hive's EQ and compressor sound great and are supremely easy to use. The EQ boasts adjustable high and low shelving bands and a sweepable mid, each with up to 15 dB of cut or boost, while the compressor combines threshold and ratio in one knob, a mount, and gives useful visual feedback with its gain reduction meter. Lastly, the reverb is an algorithmic plate model with pre-delay and high-frequency damping. The tone control offers pronounced frequency tilting, while size stretches the character of the virtual space from tight cupboard-like slapback to absolutely epic.